Welcome back for another year with Typing Club. Today we're going to take a look at some of the steps you should take to clean up your account to make sure that you're ready for the new school year. This is generally directed towards administrators or just the person who's in charge of cleaning up the account from year to year and should have hopefully access to everything on the side, including the full settings, and someone who's able to actually manage the student lists with the account. So one great first step is to go to your classes tab once you're signed into your teacher portal. A lot of folks do just completely delete classes from year to year, and you can do that without worrying because the student progress is tied to the student and the lesson plan that they're working on, not to the actual class. The class just acts like a shell that holds together the roster and a group of settings. So you can delete a class without worrying about affecting your student progress. If you know that you're wiping everything clean, you can select all and actually just go ahead and delete right here. Or you do, of course, have the option to disable. So if you prefer to just disable the class to be able to view it later, you can do that. Those will still be available for you, but the lesson plans assigned to those classes will not be available to the students. Or alternatively, if you are going to reuse your classes but want to re-roster your students, you can use the clear roster button, and that would allow you to just remove the students, not have to make new classes or redo your settings, but then you could just roster new students into those same classes. So you have all of those options right from here. If you know that you're only deleting classes from a particular date range, you could or from a particular, you know, grade or school, anything like that, you can use the filters at the top for those options. Or again, by that date option, you could do sort by created, and then you'd be able to delete things from a particular time frame. So you can use that to help you narrow down what you might need to get rid of. We are not able to recover deleted information, so you know, just once you do delete something, just make sure that you're ready to do it. Okay, so let's move on to students. So that's, you know, just clearing up our classes and getting ready for adding our new classes. The next thing that we would want to do is double check our student list. So again, you can use the filters here to narrow down your population, or you can use any of the sort options here by first name, last name, or grade. So for instance, if you know that your, let's say your seventh graders, okay, we don't have any seventh graders, maybe your sixth graders are not going to use the program, you can come here, you can select all or just select, I've just got the one, and then you can delete them so that they will come off of your student list. Again, similarly, do remember if you delete the student, then they are permanently gone from the program along with their progress. So just a heads up there. So looking back at our full student list, you know, another handy button that we put in there for you, if everyone more or less has been promoted to a new grade, you can select all and then hit move up one grade. And that, again, is not an undoable action, but it will change everyone from whatever their current grade is up to the next grade. So everyone who was a first grader would become a second grader, and so on. So hopefully that can be a handy button for you there. So that's a good way just to make sure that every student that's in your account is a student that you want to have access to Typing Club and is using up one of your licenses for this coming year. The next thing that we'll do, if you have a new school, great, you can go ahead and add it or make any changes there as needed. And then, of course, if you have any instructors who are new to the program, you can go ahead and add them. If it's a small number, add them one by one here, and then you'll have them all ready and set. We'll send an email to them so that they can create their password and get logged in. Another good thing to do is to check out your lesson plans. We have a lot of new content being added, so it's not a bad idea to check out your lesson plan library. New this year, we have Jungle Junior for kindergarten and first grade, so that's something that you can make use of. We also have a new story typing lesson plan that's called The Perfect Match, and that's about a boy. It's a sci-fi story, so that's a new one out there for you. And then we do also have a number of new languages available, so if anyone's interested in typing in another language, we now have French, German, Italian, Portuguese, and Slovak. So if you want to make use of any of those, they are completely available for you there. After you've installed any new lesson plans you want, if we go back to our lesson plan list, another really good idea is to double check any of your Ed Club managed lesson plans, which you'll see with the check mark. It's a good idea just to see if there have been any updates. So you can see that by clicking the name of the lesson plan. Oh, and sure enough, we have an option here to upgrade to the latest version. Now what that will do is bring in any changes we've made and bring in any new lessons we've added. So for instance, this year we did add new dynamic lessons. So I'm gonna actually go ahead and upgrade my lesson plan. And hopefully that will just take a second. While it's upgrading, I'll tell you a little bit about the dynamic lesson plans, or lessons. They are specific to each student. So we begin those in the basic level one, and you'll see those towards the end of every section from there on forward. And they actually analyze each student's profile and will give them combinations of letters and words that are specifically troublesome for that student. So those are new, so if you upgrade your lesson plan, you'll get those automatically. So that's just one good step, so just make sure you're fully upgraded. And then another good thing to double check is, if you look up here, we have the default lesson plan settings. Now what you can do there is control what's assigned to newly created classes. So before you create your new classes, it's a good idea just to double check, okay, is this actually the lesson plan that I want to assign by default to any grade that I don't give another default to? So for instance, Typing Jungle Edited, I'm okay with using that one again for this year, so I'll leave that, but I could use any other lesson plan in my account. And then you might want to, you know, for first grade, for instance, you might want to go ahead and say, I actually would prefer to use Jungle Junior. So that's just something to keep in mind. You can make use of those options there. You don't have to use any of these. If you just use the default lesson plan, then you can always change the lesson plan on a class-by-class basis later. And please don't forget to hit Save Changes before you actually exit. So once we know that our lesson plans and our defaults are all up to date, then we can think about adding our new classes. So when you want to add your classes, there are two different ways to go about doing that. You can add them on a class-by-class basis, depending on how many you're adding. Your teachers can, of course, make use of our Google Classroom integration, so if you're allowing them to sign into the program and roster their own classes, they can do that. Or if you are adding a number of classes, then you might be familiar with our data import tool, which sits under Settings and Data Import Tool. And under this, this tool, you can add new schools, instructors, classes, and students. We have a pretty well-rounded support center, which is actually new, and we have a lot of information there about using the Data Import Tool, so definitely make use of that. Or, of course, you can always reach out to us at Typing Club Support, and we will give you a hand getting all that set up. If you are going with that process, then we do suggest you go in the same order, and of course you can create all the new information you need step by step in this process. If you have a slightly smaller population and you're doing your classes either one by one or just your classes in bulk, the next step would be, of course, to add your new students and get everyone rostered. So one nice thing that you can do is to actually use the Update Many Students wizard. And with this wizard, if you make one CSV spreadsheet per class, what you can do is upload them here, follow the next steps, it lets you know what fields you can have and what fields you need to have. If you go to the next step, it gives you a little bit of information about how to actually generate a CSV. I'm going to go back one step actually and just download this example spreadsheet just so I have one to play with. We're going to go to the next step, and then I'm going to actually drop this example one, and that way we can get to the next step here. So then it'll actually allow me to choose what it does its best to guess the actual column header, but if anything's wrong, you can update it here, no big deal. And then you can also tell it, okay, I don't actually want to do this one, so skip. So that'll skip that one. If you have more than one school, you'll have the option to add these students to a school. And then lastly, you can choose a class. So as long as you've added your new classes, you can then add this whole list of students to a particular class. So that makes it a one-step process for you as far as getting the kids created and enrolled. Now this doesn't only have to be for new students, you can actually use this for your existing students to roster them. So you can do both in the same step. So if we go ahead and finalize import, let's see, okay, I didn't remove that column, or that row rather, from my CSV, so of course that would fail since it's not actually a student, but now we see success, students' information was updated and they were subscribed to the fourth grade curriculum class. So if we pop back over to classes now, and we go to fourth grade library curriculum, I went from two students earlier to now I have four. Mary and John were created and enrolled in their class. So that's one nice way, depending on the number of classes that you're trying to roster, to get your new students added and into their classes. Another thing to think about with your students is whether or not you'd like them to start over, or whether or not you want them to pick up from where they left off. Typing Club will not delete any student data. We leave everything intact. That's entirely up to you. So if you know that, you know, you want your students to begin again from lesson number one and start over, what you can do is, you can even leave that to the teacher. So if you go to the particular class and you go to the lesson plan that they're working on, and choose the scoreboard, you can clear the progress for an entire class. So again, that's going to your classes, choosing the class, the lesson plan you want them to start over on, and then the scoreboard, and you can click clear progress. Or if there's just one particular student who wants to start over, or you would like to have start over from the beginning, you can reset their progress on a student-by-student basis. Now do keep in mind, as with other types of data in our program, this is permanent action, and once you've removed that student data, we're not able to recover it, so just, you know, make sure before you do go ahead and confirm that that is what you definitely want to do. So that's pretty much most of how to get your account up and ready for the new year. If you do have any questions, again, we have that nice help center that you can always check out. There's a lot of information in there. We actually have a really great back to school section. So if you hit FAQ and then back to school, we have a nice breakdown here, as well as some questions and answers that we really hope will help. And then of course, as always, we have our helpful support team. So you can create a ticket right from your support tab and just reach out to us, let us know what we can help with. I hope that that's been helpful and a nice, quick, hopefully not too long summary of how to get ready for this new school year. We wish everyone a very happy and successful school year ahead, and we look forward to working with you again. Take care.